I am Raj Banerjee, and I'm an associate professor in the Department of Materials Science and Engineering here at UNT, but also the director of the ISES program at UNT, and ISES stands for the Institute for Science and Engineering Simulation.
Hi, I'm Angela Wilson. I am a professor of chemistry and the co-director of the Center for Advanced Scientific Computing and Modeling.
My name is Alan Needleman. I'm a professor of materials science and engineering at the University of North Texas.
Broadly speaking, what we are trying to achieve in ISES is the ability to converge or to bring together modeling and simulation that is carried out in a computer together with experimental work which is carried out on very fancy, expensive equipment. By doing this, what we can achieve is a very cost and time effective solution to a lot of problems that are faced by the US Air Force, the Department of Defense, industry in general, and also a lot of other commercial industries that we work with.
A benefit of computational modeling is that there's often experimental problems that are very difficult to isolate. It's very difficult to look at short-lived species. It's very difficult to really understand what's happening often at the interface. And so computational methods can be used to understand phenomena such as those.
The rules that we use to understand and predict things are basic laws of physics, like conservation of energy, conservation of momentum. Then we combine those with models. There are many different time and length scales involved. Times from less than a millionth or a billionth of a second up to a million years for an earthquake, or a thousand hours or thousands of hours for an engine.
So modeling and simulation is what we carry out using some advanced computers, some state-of-the-art computational facilities that are existing at UNT today that allow us to find out how, for example, a particular component in an aircraft, okay, it could be a piece of a jet engine, it could be a component that is in the wing of the aircraft, how these particular components can fail, and how does that then affect the performance of that particular component. And using that information, we can try to find out how we can stop that failure from happening.
For example, if you want to know how a crack grows, say, in a jet engine, right at the very tip of the crack, say, a few atoms of oxygen or hydrogen may greatly influence how the crack propagates.
UNT very cleverly put together a cluster of people aim to do work in materials modeling, ranging from very small scale, atomic scale work like I do, all the way through nearly device level. And so truly it is very essential that these groups work together hand in hand, passing on information from one scale, one atomic level scale, to the next level scale, all the way working towards real life materials.
So if you try to do only experiments, it's ineffective. If you try to do only computation, you will never reach the final answer. So how do you do the best or the most efficient way? Bring the two together. You do some experiments, use that information, feed it into your computer models. Let the computer models take up from there onwards, and then give you an answer back, which we can test using an experiment.